In this video, we introduce the idea of electromagnetic induction, then we introduce Lenz's law and the idea of magnetic flux as a way to talk about induction more precisely. Finally, we work a couple qualitative examples of induced current in order to clarify Lenz's law. We start with a simple experiment with a bar magnet and a coil of wire on the left. In the top picture, we're approaching a coil of wire with the north pole of a magnet. And what we observe in the coil, assuming that its terminals are connected so current is allowed to flow, what we observe is a current flowing in the shown direction. Then if we allow things to settle down for a second, and we suddenly remove that north pole of the magnet, we'll see current induced in the opposite direction in the coil. So what's going on here? To clarify this behavior, we first introduce the idea of magnetic flux. Magnetic flux is a way of talking about how many magnetic field lines are penetrating a loop. And we're going to quantify this in the next video when we talk about the change in flux and Faraday's law. For now, we're just trying to cover it qualitatively. So what I have in the picture is just some arbitrary surface, and I called that A, and the perimeter of that is a conductive loop. And I have this green vector called a normal vector that's perpendicular to the surface element. And that's how we talk about the orientation of surfaces, because it's so much easier than talking about the actual angle of the surface. So this normal vector is just perpendicular to the surface. I've also shown three magnetic field lines that are penetrating the loop. So these are the points where they actually cross the surface, right here where the color changes, here, here, and here. So in this picture, I have three magnetic field lines penetrating the surface. And when we quantify that appropriately, that's called the magnetic flux through the loop. Notice that the magnetic field isn't coming in exactly perpendicular to the surface. And we talk about that degree of alignment with this angle theta between the magnetic field and the normal vector. So I have some magnetic field coming through with a component in the same direction as the normal vector in this picture. So flux is the amount of magnetic field poking through a loop. And Lenz's law tells us that the induced current, or possibly just the EMF, if the circuit isn't completed, will act in the direction that opposes the change in flux. So when I go back to our experiment, the reason the current is induced in this direction is because the loop has been exposed to new flux pointing rightward through the loop. So the current is induced in the direction that will reduce that change. In other words, the direction that creates leftward magnetic field lines coming through the loop. If I point my thumb in the direction of current and loop my hands around using the Ampere's law right hand rule, I see that this current is in exactly the right direction to oppose the change in flux coming through the loop. Likewise, in the second picture, we allowed everything to settle down with a bunch of rightward magnetic fields poking through the loop due to the magnet. But then when we removed the magnet, the loop is going to try to sustain that rightward flux through its interior. Again, using the Ampere's law right-hand rule, I see that this current direction gives me magnetic field lines pointing rightward through the loop as the loop struggles to maintain the original magnetic field. Let's wrap things up with a couple qualitative examples. In the first example, I have a loop sitting in the plane of the page, and a magnetic field is suddenly turned on pointing out of the page. I'm asked to draw the direction of the induced current here. Well, this is a bunch of new outward flux through the interior of the loop, and the loop is going to respond by creating inward flux to try to keep that original flux of zero through its interior. Using the Ampere's law right-hand rule, I can kind of guess and check with my thumb in one direction and the other direction. And the way that gets it done is by using a clockwise current. So I stick my thumb in that direction, my fingers loop inward through the interior of the loop, and this loop is now opposing the change in flux. In my second example, I have a loop sitting in the plane of the page, and it's experiencing an outward magnetic field. Now just to keep track of the orientation of the loop, we're using a normal vector. So this is a vector perpendicular to the area captured by the loop. It's pointing out of the page as well. So I have a bunch of field lines poking out through the loop at this moment. Then I quickly rotate the loop by 90 degrees, making the normal vector perpendicular to the magnetic field. In other words, the face of the loop is now parallel with the magnetic field. So in my initial state, there's a bunch of field lines coming out in the same direction as the normal vector. In the final state, there are no magnetic field lines penetrating the surface of the loop because the surface is parallel to the magnetic field. So the loop is going to respond by trying to generate magnetic field lines pointing in the same direction as the normal vector. in order to sustain that original magnetic field that agreed with the normal vector direction. So I could call that the induced magnetic field. Then I just have to figure out which way is the current going to run in order to create those induced magnetic field lines. It's a little hard to see perspective in this picture, but where my pen is right now is the near side of this loop. And if I run the current down on that near side face, I put my thumb in the direction of the current, wrap the fingers of my right hand around through the loop. That's going to generate the correct induced field. On the far side of the loop, that current will be moving upward. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.